gentlemen, I have a renowned announcement to make. What? I was fixing it, addition all that. What? Okay, come here. Okay, she thinks that I can't announce her like she deserves to be announced, so I want you to give it a try. Where'd you come from, prima donna?
I missed her by your sister.
Oh?
Yes.
What?
You want to tell them who I am? Or shall I?
Maybe you should tell
them. Apparently, we can't do it good enough.
I think you should just introduce yourself, girl. Come on over here, Missy. Let's make her happy.
I'm Kid Pearl, everybody. Howdy.
I love you.
Hey, Johnny, I saw your first cousin yesterday. You know Melvin?
Yeah, the one that like hates the bait so bad, even when he goes into town, the sewer is back out.
And they do. They do. Hey, Gina, I went to the nursing home the other day to see my grandma.
How's she doing?
She's doing good. I asked her, I said, Grandma, how does it feel to be 93 years old, honestly? How does it feel? She said, I feel like a newborn baby. Don't have no teeth, don't have no hair, and I just peed myself. No. I got called to be on the jury last week.
I hate that. I hate that.
I'm telling you, I really lost so much respect for lawyers. I thought they were so much smarter than these lawyers.
What's wrong?
Oh my goodness. Well, first off, this lawyer asked this person on stand, said, you got children? He said, yep. He said, how many you got? Witness said, I got three. He said, are any of them boys? He said, nope. Are any of them girls? And I'm thinking, did that guy just pass the bar exam and ask that? And then he was asking, he said, doctor, now when someone dies in their sleep, they don't realize they're dead till the next morning, right? So I'm wondering how these attorneys got their job, because I think I could do better than that. At least I'd know that they knew they died when they died.
That dog could do better than that.
That dog could do better than that. You know my brother. Y'all have all heard about my brother.
Are you supposed to talk about him?
Well, he's not here, so I can say whatever I want.
Keep that pig under wraps, or I will take it off the stage.
My brother's here. That's him making a noise.
Brother's a pig?
My brother's a pig. He's a pig. Yeah, he went to the doctor last week. He's kind of a hypochondriac. And he said, doctor, I'm hurting all over. Everywhere I touch, it hurts. And the doctor said, well, show me where. And he said, oh, right there. Oh, right there. Oh, right there. He said, doctor, what's wrong with me? And the doctor said, well, you got a broke finger. Right. And last month, brother went in and he had two burnt ears. And the doctor said, brother, how'd you burn them ears? He said, I was ironing my shirt, getting ready for church. And the telephone rang, and I answered it. He said, well, that explains that ear. But what happened to the other ear? He said, they called back. You know, brother wasn't borrowing too much sense. Yeah. Well, me and Mabel went down to get beautified the other day to the beauty shop.
She needs it.
Yes, she does, bless her heart. We never did get her bath taken, but we're going to get her beautified. And the beautician looked at us and said, you got sisters? And I looked at her and I said, no, we've never even been in a Catholic church. Our preacher was preaching last Sunday and he said, the Bible says, and when we take those vows, it's for better or for worse. He said, but I thought my wife was losing her hearing, and I was going to prove that it was for better or worse. He's exhausted in the hallway, and I said, baby, can you hear me? She didn't answer. So he crept up, and he said to the doorway, he said, baby, can you hear me? She still didn't answer. So he got right up behind her and whispered in her ear and said, baby, can you hear me? She said, for the third time, I can hear you. Y'all enjoy the rest of the show.